So here we are in Punchbowl Cove with a fantastic 3,000 foot tall Punchbowl Cliff right behind us. So the geology in here, so this is a glacially carved fjord. So you'll look at the top of the mountain and you can see it's rounded. And that's because Rudyerd Bay here has had multiple glaciation periods. So at one point, the glacier is completely covered even over the top of the mountains. And then those once receded and a second glaciation period came in that was much lower and kind of carved out the fjords and the natural cracks and low spots on the rock. There's a lot of granite here, and granite forms by, it's basically lava or magma that cools very slowly deep underneath the ground. So it cools very slowly and it forms the natural structure of the rock, are these like onion domes with layers. So as you go throughout Rudyerd Bay, if you think of the natural rock as like an onion with layers, and then the way that the glacier carved out, you can see the layers of the onion. And if you cut an onion in half and you have the vertical layers like that, that's very strong, and that's where you'll get like Punchbowl. You see all those vertical layers, and so you can get the very steep vertical cliffs. And then other areas where it might be the rounded part of the onion, those are going to be not as strong, and you know, it'll be, things will slough off and you won't get quite the steep vertical cliffs as it carves out. Basically the underlying rock here is the granite that was formed deep within the earth and was then uplifted. And we've had multiple glaciation periods that have carved out this fjord. But at one point, this fjord was carved out and then the glaciers receded, and then there was volcanic activity that filled this Punchbowl Cove in full of lava. And then a second glaciation period came in and basically carved out a big chunk of that lava, exposing the granite again. But if you look in the back of Punchbowl Cliff, all this darker rock is much younger basalt, which is a more or less a fast hardening, you know, it's a similar chemical structure, but it's from volcanic activity, and it basically hardens on the surface instead of deep within the earth. So it comes out with a smaller crystal structure and ends up with that darker color.